Hello everyone. Today I'm going to present our recent research, The Traumatic Life Experience and Ontological Well-being: Insights from Narrative Psychology and Self-Memory Theory. The turbulent external conditions, environmental triggers as the pandemic outbreak and related socioeconomic social challenges lead to traumatic experiences for individuals. So being exposed and experiencing these kind of events lead to several damages for individual psychological well-being. It affects individual's mental health, and eventually it will negatively affect working adults, work performance, and related organizational behavior. So studying these kind of concepts as the trauma and traumatic experience of individuals are important for our understanding in organizational behavior. Based on this logic, this study aims to contribute to the current knowledge on ontological well-being. Specifically, this research intends to reveal the impacts of post-traumatic stress disorder on ontological well-being of individuals in work life. It's important to note that PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder, is a clinical term and it's classified as a mental disorder, and also it definitely needs attention from of a mental health professional, psychologist, psychiatrist. This research is not aiming a clinical assessment, diagnosis, or provide solutions, provide suggestions for PTSD treatments. Rather than, we are focusing on determining and describing PTSD symptoms and the experiences of traumatic life events and experience of individuals and its effect on their well-being. So we are not aiming a clinical diagnosis. It's important to note that. In order to understand several attitudes and behaviors in social context as organizations, a traumatic experience of individuals needs attention from organizational scholars, and we can understand several attitudes and behaviors of individuals if we understand their traumatic life experiences. And based on this, we develop our hypothesis, and we are saying that perceived post-traumatic stress disorder symptoms negatively influence ontological well-being of individuals. You can see our conceptual research model. Well-being especially has been studied by scholars in recent years. Because of the effects and extension of positive psychology and positive organizational behavior, well-being, resilience, happiness, life satisfaction has been important research concerns in the literature, and there are of course several classifications of well-being. This study focused on ontological well-being, since it's a more holistic approach and it's relatively new concept. We told it it's important to expand the current knowledge on ontological well-being. Ontological well-being refers a cognitive and emotional evaluation of individuals. More specifically, it refers to individuals' assessments and evaluations of their life as a project by considering life has three dimensions as past, future, and present. So it's a more holistic approach and an umbrella concept, and also it includes the several assumptions of narrative psychology and self-memory theory. For example, narrative psychology states that individuals as the authors of their own personal stories that only be evaluated by themselves. So narrative psychology examines individuals' life experiences as narrative, which includes several dimensions as past, present, maybe future, and individuals are the authors of their own life stories. Relatedly, self-memory theory suggests that individuals' cognitions are important for their evaluations of their life. So individuals have some kind of coding, which we know as cognitions, and these cognitions affect individuals' self-memory, and they remember something, they evaluate, they perceive something based on their cognitions, their coding. So every individual has his or her own kind of self-memory, self-processing style, which reflects their understanding of their life events. For example, an individual perceives something as bad, while the other individuals perceive the same thing as good. This differentiates self-memory. This differentiates according to self-memory of individuals. To sum up, ontological well-being reflects, captures all the narrative psychology and self-memory assumptions, and it basically states that individuals has their own kind of affective and cognitive life evaluations, and these evaluations can be extended to all time perspectives, past, present, and future. Of course, this kind of holistic approach has been found as related to several psychological factors. For example, attachment, maladaptive schemas, emotional intelligence, depression, parenting styles, emotional well-being. And there are, of course, some gaps in the literature. So this subject is still to be addressed within different research frameworks. In particular, post-traumatic stress disorder is a mental disorder, as I mentioned before, and the symptoms related to traumatic life experiences has to be studied with its effect on ontological well-being of individuals. This sample of our study consists of 2,070 participants. Most of our participants were females, and most of them are coming from a middle income level. They reported in that way. And most of our participants were single individuals. We used two scales, and two of them, of course, were validated and lots of research provided their reliability before. We used a checklist to diagnose individuals' post-traumatic stress symptoms. And this research used 70 items to assess individuals' post-traumatic stress disorder symptoms. In the recent version, DSM-5, which is the most recent version of diagnosis of mental health classifications. This research has not a clinical diagnosis aim, so we used a general checklist which has been validated before this research. And ontological well-being was measured by Şimşek and Kocayörük's scale, and this scale consists of 24 items. And the scale assesses individual self-assessments for their past, present, and future. So there are four sub-dimensions as nothingness, activation, regret, and hope. As I said before, reliability and validity were showed before our research. We also showed the items, the scales of our quest, our research to five professors, and we somehow confirmed the face validity of the scales. Further, exploratory factor analysis was performed, and then we also found the scales as reliable and valid. Later correlation analysis and regression analysis were performed to evaluate the relationship between the research variables. And we found that post-traumatic stress disorder explains 11% of the change in present time activation, 40% of change in past time regrets, and relatively low change in future hope, and 31% of change in present time negativeness perception. So this regression model was found significant for research model, and our hypothesis was supported. PTSD significantly predicted each of the components of ontological well-being, and it's seen that PTSD has the minimum exploratory power in future hope, but strongest exploratory power on present time negativeness perception, as we can see from the table. The results show that our hypothesis was supported, as I mentioned before, and the results provide implications for today's work-life mental health and ontological well-being of employees. So employers need to consider the effect of traumatic life experiences in order to understand employees' well-being, performance, and general organization behavior and attitudes. So the finding of this study may contribute to the literature and works on especially positive organizational behavior and workplace health. As a limitation, it suggested that the sample size should be larger in order to enable a better generalizability of the findings. Also, demographic characteristics may change the association. So in future studies, we are suggesting that maybe demographic characteristics may be included in the research model as a moderating variables. Thank you for your attention and thank you for your listening.